Here I have a Hangout world, and I like to add some pens for people to draw with. Here's how I go about doing that. Now, as is a fairly common item in VRChat, there are already prefabs out there that are much better than what I can teach in a short tutorial. So instead, this tutorial will be covering how to add a pen prefab into a world. Now, a great place I like to go to get prefabs is VRChatPrefabs.com's database. To get there, just go to VRChatPrefabs.com and click on Database. Here we are on the first tab. This tab contains must-have prefabs like Udon Sharp, which allows you to do scripting in a much more traditional manner, Cyan Emu, which allows you to test your worlds in Unity instead of having to go build and test, and Cyan Trigger, which aims to make VRChat's SDK 3.0 work much like SDK 2.0 while still allowing other Udon scripts to work. With that said, there are other tabs as well. We will be going to the Udon Prefabs tab, but they also have assets for avatars and shaders too. Now if we go inside the Udon Prefabs tab, we want to go Control F and search for pens. The ones we'll be using today is Vertex Color Pens, an asset made by Z3Y? Yeah, if you're watching this, sorry for butchering your name. Now anyways, this is a great simple pen asset with a bunch of great stuff under the hood. But personally, I've also used Architect's pen asset, which is a pretty advanced one that has a menu to change color, size, and even a setting to draw straight lines. Though in my testing, they are a little unintuitive to use if you haven't used them before. Another one that's pretty popular is QV pens that can be found on Booth. These are also a great simple pen asset, but they do, however, require you to change some settings when you want to make the quest version of your world. They also require a new material for each pen, making adding new pens with new colors a bit of a pain, making them a little annoying to use. Luckily, however, the installation of any of these pens asset is pretty much the same, so feel free to choose whatever one you like, provided it's for SDK 3.0. Anyways, coming back to the database, when I click on the download link for Vertex Color Pens, I am sent to its GitHub. I want to scroll down to Download, and I want to click on the Unity package to download the asset. Now, this asset, like many others, requires Udon Sharp. So, coming back to the database, I want to click on the Must-Haves tab, and I want to click on the download link for Udon Sharp. Now, at the time of recording this, it actually sends us to the old GitHub, so I just want to click on this link. And now that I'm in the correct GitHub, I want to scroll a wee way down and click here to get the latest release. And now I want to download the Unity package. So now that we have all the Unity packages we need, we want to open up Unity and then open up their containing folder. As Udon Sharp is a requirement for these pens, we want to install that first. To install it, simply drag and drop them into the project window in Unity. After it's finished unpacking the asset, it will ask for what parts of the asset we want to install, and we want to install everything, so we just want to leave everything ticked and click Import. Now give it a bit to install, and now that we have Udon Sharp installed, we want to do the same for the pens. For the pens, however, do take note of what the top folder is called when importing, as we'll need to know its name later to find the asset in our files. So, now that the pens have installed, we want to go into our project window and find the folder Prefabs, which is the name of the folder for our pens. When we open it, we will see a folder called Vertex Color Pens, and when we open that folder, we will see all the files for our pens, including a couple of prefabs. I want to drag and drop the prefab called Pens Prefab into my scene. And now if we just adjust its position and rotation, we now have successfully added some pens into our world. Awesome! So now if we want to add some more pens to our world, we can click on one of our pens, go into the hierarchy and select the pen prefab itself, and we can go Control D to duplicate it. Now we can move it, and if we come up into the inspector, we can click here to change its color. I'm going to choose cyan. We can also edit its smoothing, as well as its vertex distance, which is the distance in between the points that make up the curve. The more points you have, the better the curve at the cost of performance. Awesome, so now it's time to test this. So now that we're in the world, I can pick up the pen and draw with it. I can click on the eraser on the pen to erase everything that I've drawn, or I could use one of these erasers to erase just one or two lines. Awesome. So hopefully this was helpful for you. Feel free to leave a like on the video if you liked it, leave a comment down below if you have any questions, and feel free to check out some of my other tutorials that I have on the channel. But until next time, bye!